as we already know, conflict is serious disagreement between two or more parties. So when you are under conflict, you need to determine your intention, and your intention may be competing, accommodating, collaborating, compromising, or avoiding. But fact is, which one you are going to apply? And in this video, we are going to see that which intention should be applied at which situation. So first one is competing. Under competing situation, you are going to compete with the another party, and you will not give any discount on your interest. So when quick decisive action is required to cope with the crisis on important issues where unpopular solution must be implemented, and such a situation competing is necessary. One issue is vital to organization's welfare where your group is certain that this position is correct. You will apply competing against the groups who take advantages of non-competitive behavior. Next one is accommodating. Under accommodating, you are going to accept the other party's request at the cost of you. You sacrifice your interest and you accept the another party's interest or request. So accommodating style will be appropriate when your group is wrong and wants both show reasonableness and to encourage the expression of a more appropriate view. When issues are more important to group other than yours, to satisfy others and maintain the cooperation, you are going to maintain the cooperation. That's why you are accommodating. To build credits or rank behaviors for later issues, to minimize losses when your group is outmatched and losing when harmony and stability are especially important. In this situation, you are going to apply the accommodating style. Next one is avoiding. Under avoiding, you are not going to give importance to your interest and not also in other party's interest. So when a conflict is trivial or more important conflicts are pressing, you have other issues that need to be given importance rather than this issue, and that's why you are avoiding this and going to give importance on another issue. When there is no chance that your group will satisfy its own needs, when the cost of potential disruption outweigh the benefits of the resolution, to let groups cool down and gain perspective, when others can resolve the conflict more efficiently, then you do not give importance on the issues. Next thing is collaborating. Under collaborating, both the parties, you and other party, is going to give highest importance to both of the parties' interest and going to solve the problem. So in this situation, when you will apply this situation to find an integrative solution when conflicting concerns are too important to be compromised. When most important objective is to learn, you will apply collaborating when to gain commitment through the development of the consensus, to work through conflicting feelings in individuals and between groups. Next one is compromising style. This compromising style is very much effective when group concerns are important but not worth the disruption of more assertive style. When equally powerful groups are committed to pursuing mutually exclusive concerns, to achieve temporary or transitory settlements, you will compromise. To arrive at expedient resolutions under the time pressure, that's why you will sacrifice. And next one is as a backup when neither competing nor problem-solving styles are successful. That's why you will compromise to reach to a solution.